Hello everyone, welcome to the series of Project Dissertation and Implementation introduced by Technolytics, TechIT Easy. In this video series, we are going to learn about how to complete project dissertation successfully. This video series is important for the students who are going to make their project in the UG or PG level, especially in the final year. In our last videos, we have seen the topics such as how to select the project topic, how to create title page, pro forma, how to create life company or college certificate, how to create abstract, etc. And I had also taught you how to create table of content manually. But today in this video, I'm going to teach you how to create table of content automatically. And the same way, how to create list of figures and list of tables automatically. So let's begin with this video. So here steps are given for creating a table of contents, but instead of going through all these steps, I will show you practically how to do this. All these steps I will be giving in the description box from where you can easily get it and download. So let's begin. I'm just opening my Microsoft Word document. This application I'm going to use for creating table of content automatically. So I'll just write on top the heading as table of content. Okay. And after that, I'll just leave one line because I want this table of content on top. Okay. So first of all, we need to decide that what will be your first heading, what will be your heading 2, heading 3, and likewise, you can decide that headings. Okay, so my very first heading, I think, short English poem, this title, I want to keep it as my heading 1. So I'll just select it and I will just go on home menu and here various styles are there. You all can see, yahan pe styles tab hai. So heading 1 is there. I'm just selecting it. Suppose I want to modify this heading. I'll just right click on it. And then here modify option is there. So I just want to make it Times New Roman. And size 20, okay, bold. And I want it in the center line. Okay, so these all formats I want. Okay, and I'm clicking on okay. So I have modified this. This is my heading 1. Now for my poem heading, I'll just select my poem heading and I will select it as my heading 2. But I don't want it in the center. So I'll just right click on this style heading 2. I'll click on modify and I'll just change the alignment to left. Okay, and rest all things are okay for me. So I'm clicking on okay. Now my heading 1 style is ready. My heading 2 style is ready. Now let's select the poem name and make it of the style heading 2. Okay, so it is picking the same style of heading 2, which we created on top. Then again, I'm selecting this heading 2. Okay, then I'm just moving back, moving down and selecting the last topic and just making it all heading 2. Now guys, I'm having heading 1 topic for my main topic, that is short English poems. This is my heading 1 and all the topics of poem names I have made it as heading 2. So now let's see the magic automatically how you can get table of content. So here again I'm clicking on references and table of content, and table of content you can see 3 types of templates are already available for you. Either you can select any one of it or you are having a chance to get the customized table of content. Okay, for example, if I'm clicking on customized table of content, you can see the tab header, tab leader is there. So what is this? You can select either you want dotted lines in between, or maybe hyphen you want, or underscore. Also, you can select the levels. So at what level, till what depth you want the table of content, you can select. So 5, 6, 7, but currently I just want till depth 2. So I'm just selecting heading 1 and heading 2, because heading 1 would be my main topic and heading 2 would be the names of my poems. So I want only till level 2. So I'm just clicking on OK. And you can see our table of content is ready. So table of content here, you can see, since I had given the heading before, so this I can remove. But for this table of content also, it has given the page number. So in case if I'm removing it, it will go. Let's see. Still it is visible. So what we shall do, I need to update it. So for updating, just simply click on references and click on update table. You can see my table of content has gone and mera table of content update hua hai. So here you can see, for example, if short English poems is on page number 1 and all 1, 2, 3, 4, you can see with little bit tab space, all these names are visible. So how it created automatically, in case if I'm creating another page, or else let's do one thing, this Baba Black Sheep, let's see the page number. Currently Baba Black Sheep is on page number 4. Okay, you can see over here. Let's move it on page number 5 and see the magic. So in case it happens now, sometimes we make changes in our document and then automatically the page number should get affected. So it's on page number 5 right now. You all can see 5 page number. So let's see the table of content on top. So I can see still it is on page number 4. Why? Because I have not updated this table. So let's update. In the references menu, you can see update table is there. Simply click on it. Here it is giving me two options, that is update page numbers only. So you just want to update page numbers or entire table. So that's your choice. So accordingly, just simply select the required option and you can see the change updated table with page numbers are there. Okay. So this is how you can get automatically table of content. So isn't it so amazing? Likewise, let's see how to get the list of figures. So here you can see multiple figures are there for each and every poem. So what you have to do, first you just have to select a figure for which you want to give number or listing. And then here in the references tab, you are having an option that is insert caption. Click on insert caption. Figure 1, you can give little lamb. Okay, this is a figure. Okay, so I'm selecting figure. And for this figure, I have given the caption as little lamb. Even you can remove this figure 1 and simply name you can give, but I want that figure. Now here it is giving you the option, that is you can select the position, like this caption you want to give below the figure or you want to give above the figure. Okay, so I want to give this caption below the figure and I'm clicking on okay. You can see figure 1 little lamb is over here. Okay, so accordingly, I'm having other figures also. Let's give caption for this as well. So just simply click on insert caption. Figure 2, little star. I'm giving the caption as little star. I want it below the item and clicking on OK. You can see. But till now, we have just given the caption for the figures. Now how to get list of figures. So for that, let's write the heading list of figures. Okay, and here again the references and insert table of figures. Click here on this option. It is there under caption tab. So you can see figure one, how it will look in print preview and how it will look in the web preview. That is what you can see over here. And then caption label, from template, all these options are there. So let's click on OK. Great. Since I gave caption to my two figures, that is figure one, little lamb, this caption has come with the page number, and figure two, little star, this caption also has come with the figure, with the page number. So likewise, you can give caption to multiple figures in your documentation, and here on top, you can get the list of figures automatically. Okay, how the steps already I have explained you. And the same way, the table of content, how you got it automatically. So remember, two things are very important. References tab, references menu is very, very important for this kind of job. And at the same time, from home tab, you have to select the styles. Okay, these two things you remember, and easily you can get table of content, list of figures, and yes, list of tables is also same to same like list of figures. Instead of figures, you simply have to give caption to the table. That is only the difference. So I request you all to please try for list of tables as well, and give me your comments or your experiences. Share your experiences with me. Okay, in the comment boxes, you can always ask any queries if you have. So I have given these steps in the description box, guys. So you can go through it. And I hope you have learned a lot of interesting thing in today's video. So let's recap. Today we have seen how to create table of content automatically, how to create list of figures automatically, and how to create list of tables automatically. Now, using this all information or using this all knowledge, now we are going to move towards the next topic in the next video, that is chapter 2, survey of technologies. So to get the intimation of this video, please subscribe our channel and always be connected with us. For any queries, you can join our Telegram group. So this link I'm giving, I'm posting in the description box. You can post your queries on this link, and then definitely we would happily, we would be giving answers to your queries. So that's all from my side. On behalf of Team Technolytics, I thank you each and every who is listening to this video. Thank you. Take care.